Yes, coffee looks funny this morning. It's hot chocolate.
You must have pressed the wrong button.
No, it's that machine. It's done it on purpose.
Perhaps its microchips are mixed up.
I was against having that machine here in the first place. There is too much automation.
You can't stop progress.
It's progress that's got us 3 million unemployed. Before we had that machine, we had Big Elsie. She never gave me hot chocolate for coffee. That machine has done her out of a job.
She retired 3 years ago.
Never mind that. If she hadn't have retired, she'd be out of a job.
But she said she was glad to go.
Who asked for your opinion?
Are you just the fellow I've been looking for?
The answer's no.
Well, you might wait till I ask the question.
I don't need to. There's only one question you ever ask. Can I borrow a pound?
Well, that's just where you're wrong. I wasn't going to ask, could I borrow a pound?
Oh, sorry, Fred. What do you want?
Can I borrow £5?
The answer's still no.
Anyone lend me 10p for the machine?
I haven't got any change.
Me neither.
I can oblige you, Mr. Christian.
Oh, thanks, Fred.
Don't mention it. You wouldn't have a £5 note on you, be any chance?
Yes, I have.
Ah, good. I'll pay you back next week.
Just a minute. You still owe me £5 from last week.
Didn't I give you that back?
No, you didn't.
Oh, I am sorry. Look, I tell you what I do. Here's the £5 I owe you from last week. Now that leaves us straight, doesn't it? So if I borrow this, I just owe you £5, all right? Excuse me, I must have.
I've got a feeling I just lost £5.
Good morning.
Yes, what do you want?
Coffee?
Sorry, this is staff canteen, staff only.
I think I may loosely qualify as staff.
Ah, you're Mr. Dingle, the new porter.
No, I'm Mr. Crawford, your new chairman.
Oh, good Lord. Staff, on your feet. Come on, up, up.
Oh, for goodness sake, sit down.
Oh, for goodness sake, sit down.
My car broke down just along the road. Nothing my chauffeur can't deal with, so I thought I'd pop in, have a coffee while I'm waiting.
Certainly, sir. What would you like, Mr. Crawford? Coffee black, no sugar, coffee black, sugar, coffee black, extra sugar, coffee milk, no sugar, coffee milk, sugar, coffee milk, extra sugar, coffee extra milk, no sugar, coffee extra milk, sugar, coffee extra milk, extra sugar.
Coffee black, no sugar.
Certainly, sir. Coffee black, no sugar, Mr. Hardy.
Coffee black, no sugar, Mr. Wilkins.
Coffee black, no sugar, Miss Clark.
Are you Mr. Slinger, the manager?
No, sir, no. Not yet, sir. I hope to be one day, of course, sir. A manager, sir, not Slinger.
Where is Slinger?
He's gone to the bank, sir. She'll be back any minute.
After you, beauty before age. Are you all right?
Oh, I don't feel very well.
Oh, what's the matter?
I had a Chinese last night.
What, you do out of business hours? It's your own business.
A Chinese meal.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry, I see what you mean. Yeah.
I think I ate something that upset me.
Oh, yeah, what did you have?
Well, I started off with spare ribs, then I had special fried rice, chop suey, chicken chow mein, prawn balls, sweet and sour pork, bean shoots, crispy noodles, and a portion of chips.
I think you overdid it.
Yeah, shouldn't have had the chips. Couldn't have eaten the prawn balls.
Oh, now, where is everybody? Don't tell me, having an early coffee break. Oh, dear. All right.
Another cup of coffee, sir?
No, thank you. Tell me, how long does it take this fellow Slinger to go to the bank?
Well, he's slowing up a little, sir. It's his age.
Really?
Yes, I do feel once one is over 50, one is on the decline.
I am over 50.
Oh, well, with all due respect, Mr. Crawford, you're not involved in the day-to-day running of a branch. One has to be alert and energetic.
Come on, you lot, back to your post. Mr. Christian, get me a cup of coffee.
Mr. Slinger.
Who are you? You don't work here.
No, I'm not alert and energetic enough.
Well, I don't know who you are or what you're selling, but this canteen is for staff only.
Does the name Crawford mean anything to you?
Crawford. Are you the dog food rep?
No.
Crawford. Now, the only other Crawford I know is Clueless Crawford.
Clueless Crawford?
Yes, our new chairman. You're not related to him, are you?
No, I'm not related to him.
Oh, good.
Clueless, is he?
Yeah, well, he's got to be, hasn't he? I mean, what does he know? I mean, what was he before he was a chairman?
An accountant, sir.
Well, there you are. What does an accountant know about slicing bacon? Nothing.
I couldn't agree more. I don't know a thing about slicing bacon.
Well, there you are, you see. You don't know anything about slicing bacon either. That was a coincidence, wasn't it? What?
Allow me to introduce myself. I am your new chairman. I believe the term you used was clueless. Yes, I know exactly what you mean. You're absolutely right. I am clueless.
You are? I mean, no. You're not Mr. Clueless. I mean, Mr. Crawford.
You see, I was appointed chairman for my financial ability, but I intend to spend a lot of time visiting our many branches, and I shall be here on Monday morning at 9 o'clock to spend the day with you.
Well, we'll certainly look forward to that, sir.
Don't lie, Slinger.
No, sir, we certainly won't be looking forward to that, sir.
Well, I must be getting along, see if my chauffeur has repaired the car.
I'll see you out, and I'll see you later.
Excuse me.
Yes, madam.
This raspberry jam.
Yes.
It says on the label it contains no additives, no colouring, and no preservatives.
That is correct.
Have you got one with no raspberries?
Pardon?
Well, you see, the seeds get under my husband's false teeth, and the trouble is he loves his raspberries.
Oh, I see. Well, why don't you try making him a jelly? A raspberry jelly. There we are, it's fine.
Well done, Slinger.
Oh, thank you, sir, it was nothing.
I shall see you on Monday at 9 o'clock.
Yes, and we're still not looking forward to it.
Cheerio, sir. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
You knew all the time, didn't you?
Didn't have time to warn you, sir.
You weasel, you're after my job, but you're not going to get it.
Mr. Slinger.
What?
Customer.
Yeah, later.
Excuse me?
Yes, what do you want? I mean, what can I do for you, sir?
It's bent.
Who is?
This tin of potatoes I bought yesterday. Look at it.
Oh, yeah, but it won't affect the potatoes.
Yes, it will. They'll be all mashed up. I want another tin.
Oh, all right. Hardy.
Yes, Mr. Slinger?
Chuck me a large tin of potatoes over.
Look, I'm busy, Mr. Slinger. I've got all these soups to reprise.
Don't argue. Do as you're told. Sling me a large tin of potatoes.
Oh, all right. Here.
You steaming great nit. Look what you've done.
Yeah, well, you're supposed to have caught it.
Yeah, but our chairman was out there. What's he going to say?
Not a lot.
Why not?
That tin of potatoes just hit him on the head.
Oh. Is it all right, Mr. Crawford?
I'm suffering extreme pain.
It's just a bruise, Mr. Crawford. I don't think it's broken the skin.
Oh, good. You must have a very thick skull. Oh, I didn't mean it like that, sir.
Shut up, Slinger.
Yes, sir, yes.
It's a good job you were wearing a hat.
Yes. I took the liberty of pouring a large brandy, sir.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Christian. Oh, I needed that.
That was for Mr. Crawford.
For Mr. Crawford? Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Crawford, yes. Oh, there's some left. I drank from that side.
I'll get you another glass, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Crawford.
Excuse me, Mr. Slinger. We chased him through the precinct, but he got away.
Oh, what a pity.
I can't understand why this fellow should want to sling a tin of potatoes through our window.
Perhaps he's an anti-potato freak, sir.
There's some funny people about, sir. There really are. I wonder what goes through their twisted minds.
I found Mr. Crawford's hat.
Don't worry.
Dented.
It's all right. I'll straighten it out for you. That won't take a...
Excuse me, Mr. Slinger. I've just been on to the glaziers and they can't put in a new window till tomorrow morning.
Well, that's rather inconvenient.
They said they'll come round this afternoon and put a tarpaulin up temporarily.
One large brandy.
Oh, God bless you, Mr.
That was for Mr. Crawford.
I'll get you another, sir.
Never mind. I really have to be going.
I'll see you out, sir.
See me out after what happened last time? Certainly not. And there's something else. Somebody will have to stay here all night to protect the stock.
Oh, yes. I shall detail one of the staff to stay.
You will stay.
Me, sir?
You are the manager.
Oh, yes, sir. What a good idea. Yes, I'll stay, sir. Yes.
Good night, Crawford.
Good night, sir. Good night, Rabbi. Rabbi Crawford. I mean, Mr. Crawford, goodbye.
Good night, Mr. Crawford.
Well, who's going to stay the night with me?
Well, don't look at me. I've got a date tonight.
Oh, she should be so lucky. Oh, it's got to be you, Fred. You're the security.
I'm sorry, Mr. Slinger. Under normal circumstances, I would stay, but I've got to comfort the widow Rafferty tonight.
Mr. Rafferty passed away 2 years ago.
Oh, she does need a powerful lot of comforting.
You Irish wolfhound. Oh, well, Wilkins, what are you doing tonight?
I promised to take me mum to a church jumble sale.
Well, make sure you get a good price for her. Hardy?
I'm sorry, Mr. Slinger. Tonight's the inaugural meeting of our new party.
New party? Mm.
Yeah, we decided the Labour movement's moved too far to the right, so we're forming a splinter group. We're going to change the political face of Parliament. Got posters up all over the country.
Oh, yeah. How many members have you got so far?
Three. It's a start.
It's a start, yeah. And why can't you stay behind tonight, Mr. Christian?
It's my cookery class, sir.
Cookery class? Cookery class?
Yes, at the technical college. I'm making a goulash.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Well, I suppose I'll have to stay here on my own.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, sir.
Oh, dear. All right, get me a cup of coffee, will you?
Yes, sir. What would you like? Coffee black, no sugar? Coffee black sugar? Coffee black extra sugar? Coffee milk?
Don't
no
start all that again. I want a white sugar, black coffee with a little drop of milk in it.
Yes, sir, right. Oh, dear.
What's the matter?
Coin seems to be jammed.
No, well, come out of the way. Come on. That's done the trick. There we are. Good. Oh, we've got two for the price. That's good, isn't it? Here we are. Hi. I think something's gone wrong. I'm running out of hands.
Well, the
yes. The thing's gone raving mad, hasn't it?
What are we going to do, sir?
Well, there's only one thing we can do. Drink it. Oh, chicken soup. Go. Go.
Office chairs.
Yeah, put it down there, that's all right.
I'm off now then, sir.
Well, so soon, it's only just closing time.
Oh, I don't want to be late for my cookery class, sir.
Oh, yeah.
How do you feel about basil?
Brush or faulty?
No. The herb. I'm putting it in the goulash. I'll bring you some tomorrow.
Oh, don't, please. You know, I've got more respect for my stomach.
Right. Good night then, sir.
Good night now. Good night. Excuse me, madam, the store's closing.
Don't be so impertinent.
All I said, madam...
I know what your intentions are. All you men are just the same, trying to chat me up.
All I'm trying to do, madam, is check you over. Check you out. Oh, dear.
Not so surprising, I suppose. A beautiful woman like me, unattached. Men are always making suggestive remarks.
Oh, really?
Take the window cleaner. Last week he knocked on the door and asked if he could fill his bucket.
That sounds perfectly innocent.
Not the way he said it. Oh. And what about the milkman?
Well, what about the milkman?
Yesterday he asked me if I wanted any extra. And last night I had one of those phone calls.
Oh, no. Obscene?
Disgusting.
Oh, did you get any heavy breathing?
He didn't just breathe, he spoke.
Oh, but what did he say?
Sorry, wrong number.
I've locked up the back, Mr. Slinger.
Oh, good.
So I'd be off then.
Yeah, well, watch yourself with that widow Rafferty.
We might go to confession afterwards.
Confession? Will that be necessary?
Oh, God willing.
Yeah. Well. Good night, Mr. Slinger.
Good night, girls. Be good.
Don't be such a spoil sport. I'm going now, Mr. Slinger. Best of luck tonight.
No, thank you. Are you the last two?
I think so. Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Ain't you scared, Mr. Slinger? Staying here all night on your own?
No, why should I be?
Well, you could get mugged. Or even murdered.
Oh, well, that's a nice thing to say.
I'm sure you'll be all right, Mr. Slinger. I'll see you in the morning.
All right.
You're still alive.
Get out of it. Mugged, murdered. Ridiculous. There's nothing at all to be afraid of. Hello? Anybody there? Who's there? I know there's somebody there. Who is it?
It's me.
Who's me?
Just call me Basher.
What do you want?
You.
There's not just me here, you know. There's half a dozen of us. Are you there, friend?
To be sure I am, Mr. Slinger.
Are you there, Jock?
Right behind you, Mr. Slinger. We're all every 6'4" of me. Oh, we're all here.
Are you there, Hardy?
Yeah, I'm here, Mr. Slinger.
Good boy, Hardy.
Hardy!
Sorry, Mr. Slinger. Just having a bit of fun.
Yeah, well, I'm not laughing, am I?
No. I thought you might want to use this radio.
What's wrong with it?
Nothing. Just to help you pass the time away during the night. It's got plug-in headphones and everything.
Oh, thank you very much.
All right, I'll be off then.
Yeah. Night. Good night. I knew it was you all the time.
Yeah.
And now it's time for Armchair Playhouse. This week, the Great Diamond Robbery. Another case for Bulldog Drummond.
Which way they go?
Evening, officer.
Which way they go?
Pardon?
I heard police whistles, gunshots.
That's right, yes.
Well, what's happened?
They've sent for Bulldog Drummond.
Bulldog Drummond?
Yeah, Bulldog Drummond, listen.
Is that you, Drummond? Yes, Inspector. Keep your head down. He's holed up in the corner house.
Good, isn't it?
About who you are and what you're doing here, sir.
Oh, my name is Cecil Slinger. I'm the branch manager and I'm guarding the supermarket till they put a new window in tomorrow morning.
You got any proof of your identity?
And what for?
Well, at the moment, I've only got your word for it that you are who you say you are. Huh. For all I know, you could be a criminal.
Ha! Do I look like a criminal?
Well, actually, yes.
Thank you very much. There we are. My driving licence, credit cards. Well, credit card. Satisfied?
Can't be too careful.
Thank you.
You staying here all night?
Yes.
Well, keep your eyes and ears open. There's a lot of rogues about at the moment, sir.
Don't worry, officer. I shall be alert and vigilant until the dawn. Warm night.
Come and look at this. Oh, look, he's asleep.
Yeah, makes him look almost human.
Shall I wake him up?
No.
I'll wake him up.
Don't you dare, Harvey.
We thought you was asleep.
No, just resting my eyes. What do you two want?
Well, I met Colin down in the pub. We thought you might fancy a can of lager and some fish and chips.
Oh, what a kind thought. I'm a bit peckish.
Unfortunately, on the way here, I drank the lager.
Oh, don't worry about that.
And I ate the fish and chips.
Still, the thought was there.
Yeah, it didn't last long, did it? I thought you were going to a jumble sale, Wilkins.
I was. I did.
Oh, yeah. Did you buy anything useful? Like a do-it-yourself brain transplant kit?
I bought a hernia belt.
I didn't know you had a hernia.
I haven't, but if I ever get one, I've got the belt for it.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. The amount of work you do here, you'll never get a hernia, mate. Never.
I hope you're going to pay for that beer, Mr. Slinger.
It's damaged stock.
That's not damaged.
It is now. That's better. And how did your political meeting go?
Oh, very well. We've been drafting out our manifesto and we come up with a vote winner, the workers' lottery.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
Well, see, a sum of £1 is collected from every citizen in the land and a weekly draw takes place, the first 50 out of the hat being the winners. Now, assume the population of the country is 50 million. That means 50 millionaires a week, which means everyone will be a millionaire by the year 22,000.
Well, personally, I don't think I can wait that long.
Well, I'm off, don't about you. I'm off home to my bed. Are you coming, Colin?
No, I'd rather go home to my own bed. Sorry about the chips.
Yeah, I'm sorry about the fish. God, dear, oh, dear.
I take you home again. Can't leave.
Oh, no. All right, Fred. Where are you?
I'm here.
Yes.
I'm here. I let myself in the back way. I need a drink.
Yeah, I think you've had enough, old sap.
No, I can always tell when I've had enough because I fall down.
And how did you get on with Widow Rafferty?
Don't talk to me about her. Oh, I found out something tonight that shocked me.
Well, nobody's perfect, Fred. I mean, everyone's got a skeleton in the cupboard.
Oh, she had more than a skeleton, and it wasn't in our cupboard, it was under the bed.
Pardon?
Big Paddy O'Reilly.
Well, maybe he was looking for something.
He was, his trousers. So I've been drowning me sorrows.
Yes, well, I think, by the look of you, I think they're well and truly sunk.
Can we? Only me.
Don't you know we're busier when we're closed than when we're open?
Just thought I'd pop round on my way home to see if you were all right.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, Fred.
Yeah, it's too early.
Pardon?
To go to bed.
Taking notice, he's elephants.
Thought you might be peckish, sir.
Oh, not the goulash.
No. Chinese takeaway. Sweet and sour pork, chicken chow mein, and fried rice.
Oh, sounds delicious.
Yes. I'll heat it up in a canteen.
I'll come with you. Right. Fred, you'll be all right here.
Oh, yeah, thanks, I will.
You will what?
Have a light beer.
Keep your thieving hands off the stock, right?
Nice.
I don't mind telling you, I can't wait till tomorrow comes.
I was thinking, Mr. Slinger, I could stay with you the rest of the night now, if you wish.
Oh, why the sudden change of heart? Oh,
well, I'm sure word has got around about our window being out. We're vulnerable to all kinds of villains. It's amazing nobody's been round already.
Yeah, and I suppose the fact that my half-year report on your progress is due has got nothing to do with your generous offer to stay.
Mr. Slinger, how could you think such a thing?
Knowing you quite easily. What's the matter?
I heard a noise.
Well, maybe it's Fred. Fred!
I think we're being burgled, sir.
No, it's probably Fred gone out.
Sounds as if he came back in again, sir.
Fred, is that you?
No.
Oh, we're in big trouble now, sir.
Yeah, don't grab hold of me. Get the dust sheet there. Now, look, I'll tell you what to do. You stay behind the door, yeah. And when he comes in, throw that over him, and I'll bash him on the head with it.
Right.
All right? Now!
Got him!
Don't get so violent. Go and phone the police. Phone the police.
Who are you?
I'm Mr. Crawford's chauffeur.
Who is Mr. Crawford?
He's just gone in there with a bottle of champagne.
Oh, my God!
Did you phone the police?
No, Mr. Slinger. I've just met Mr. Crawford's chauffeur.
What's he doing here? Oh. Quiet! Quiet!
Mr. Crawford thought a bottle of champagne might cheer you up on your vigil, sir.
Oh, what a kind thought! Where is it?
In his hand under the sheet.
Is it? Shall I get some glasses, sir?
Anybody talk to me? I'll go to the canteen for a lie down. Wake me up when the pub's open.
Morning, Shirley.
Didn't expect to see you in this morning, not after what you did to Mr. Crawford.
When I explained to Mr. Crawford that I thought he was a burglar, he commended me for my vigilance, even though it cost me four bottles of champagne.
Excuse me, Mr. Slinger, this lady's trolley's stuck.
Hardy, help the lady out with her trolley, will you?
Yes, Mr. Slinger. I can't budge it. The wheel's stuck.
Oh, come out of it. If you want a job done, do it yourself.